Ever since the release of the highly controversial fully electric Tesla Cybertruck, the public was captivated by the vehicle's virtually indestructible exoskeleton. Made out of ultra-hard 30x cold-rolled stainless steel, the same material used by SpaceX for the Starship spacecraft. The Cybertruck, with its brutalist polygonal styling and raw finish, almost looks confrontational, like it's begging you to go ahead and take your best shot, as long as you keep the caliber under 9mm. With plaid mode activated, the premium tri-motor Cybertruck will have an estimated output of 800 horsepower and 1,000 pound-feet of torque, plenty of power to propel the hefty metal box to 60 miles per hour in 2.9 seconds, and tow up to 14,000 pounds. Great for dropping jaws when the light turns green and towing a couple of four-wheelers, but could you really turn the powerful electric pickup into a serviceable light tactical vehicle? Crazy? Maybe. The Cybertruck is certainly not designed for police or military use, but the concept is definitely intriguing. We consulted with vehicle armorers, military specialists, and automotive designers to help imagine a tactical Cybertruck fit for the apocalyptic wasteland. The Cybertruck's stout build and powerful electric powertrain provide a good base for a high-mobility, up-armored vehicle, and the truck's low thermal signature and quiet electric motor make it well-suited for reconnaissance operations where stealth, mobility, and resilience are valued. Tesla founder Elon Musk famously said, "You want a truck that's really tough, not fake tough. Well, we want a truck with defensive and offensive capabilities, suitable for a variety of conflict scenarios. Let's build a hypothetical tactical Cybertruck and assess some upgrades that will make Elon's electric pickup truck fit for the modern battlefield." We asked Mark Burton, founder and CEO of ArmorMax, one of the largest designers and manufacturers of armored cars in the US, what he thinks about the Cybertruck.
First of all, I think we're really excited about the Cybertruck. And I think any level of protection is better than no protection. So what I would classify the Cybertruck at is low handgun protection. As far as on the classes and the levels and everything, it's a very basic. We could advance it to withstand high-powered rifle rounds. We could have it withstand IED blast. We could have it withstand grenades. So there's a lot of options. Being able to quickly get out of a situation offers electric vehicles a huge advantage. Because a lot of these Chevy Suburbans or Range Rovers that we're armoring, I mean, the 0 to 60 on some of those is going to be upwards of 5, 6, 7 plus seconds.
We're going to circle back to Mark in a minute to give his rundown of what features he would outfit the Cybertruck with. And he gets pretty James Bond with it, so keep watching. First and foremost, let's leverage the tri-motor Cybertruck's 3,500-pound payload capacity and adjustable air suspension to tack on some extra mass, namely in the form of a vehicular armor upgrade kit, similar to the U.S. Army Research Laboratory's Armor Survivability Kit. The additional protective armor plating, bulletproof glass, and ballistic windshield could help provide protection from small arms, explosive fragments, and rocket-propelled grenades. If they could withstand Tesla's chief designer Franz von Holzhausen's infamous steel ball is another question. The Cybertruck's unibody exoskeleton and self-leveling suspension could easily accommodate the additional 1,300 pounds of such an armor kit. Our up-armored Cybertruck is now better at defeating lateral attacks and withstanding high-caliber rifle fire, but to better protect from under-wheel IED blasts, we take advantage of the Cybertruck's 16 inches of ground clearance and add some additional shielding on the undercarriage. We want to avoid learning the unknown consequences of a 200 plus kilowatt hour lithium ion battery explosively erupting into the cabin. Blast mitigation mats in the vehicle's interior can serve to further reduce the risk of injury to the lower extremities in an underwheel explosion. We're also going to want to add run flat tires, so our hefty Cybertruck can get out of Dodge even if one of the tires gets punctured. Our Cybertruck is now a makeshift Category 1 MRAP, mine resistant, ambush protected, light tactical vehicle designed for urban operations. What about vulnerability to EMPs, electromagnetic pulse weapons? We're going to protect the Cybertruck's electronic components by wrapping them in some sort of a Faraday caging material. Remember, this project is extremely hypothetical. We want our Cybertruck to be able to dish it out as well as take it, so we might as well throw a Kongsberg M153 Crow's remotely operated weapon station on the roof. This allows our post-apocalyptic warriors to acquire and engage targets without leaving the protection of the vehicle. You use a controller inside, kind of like a video game, but way more fun. The gyro-stabilized Crow's mount is capable of 360 degrees of rotation and supports a variety of weapon systems. Our sight package includes a daylight video camera, a thermal camera, and a laser rangefinder, and we're outfitting our system with an M240 machine gun. This 7.62 caliber gas-operated machine gun can engage targets out to 1,200 meters away at an estimated 95% accuracy rate, and track moving targets at 25 miles per hour. The Crow system also supports an MK-19 grenade launcher or an M2 50 cal for more heavy-duty work. Silence is stealth, and electric is silent. Like we said earlier, those attributes make our Cybertruck well-suited for reconnaissance or scouting, the exploration of a hostile area to gain information. And we're going to want to extend the surveillance capabilities of our stealthy Cybertruck by adding a surveillance drone to perform reconnaissance and prevent us from driving into an ambush. We're going to take advantage of the Cybertruck's bed as a launch point for a Ghost UAS from Anduril. The modular Ghost is an autonomous, single-rotor, long-endurance, high-speed drone that combines point-and-click autonomous operation with the power and endurance of a helicopter. In combination with Anduril's Lattice AI operational platform, a single operator can task multiple drones to carry out a variety of missions. Once a task is set, the software handles all flight planning, maneuvering, and detection to carry out the task. This eliminates the need for a dedicated pilot and allows our Cybertruck operators to focus on other mission-critical activities, like driving or shooting the remote-operated weapon station. The Ghost UAS comes with a modular rail system with an option for a payload delivery mechanism. We could equip it with a medical kit or additional sensors, but we're going to go with a custom high-explosive airburst payload that we can drop on the heads of any hostile personnel, so we don't have to just sit there watching them plan their ambush with our hands in our pockets. As an additional countermeasure, we'd add a boomerang anti-sniper system, which uses 7 microphone sensors to immediately detect gunfire and determine shooter location. In harmony with Tesla's native cameras and sensors, we'd reprogram the DARPA-developed boomerang's output to display shooter coordinates on Tesla's own tablet. With improvised drones being one of the fastest growing threats on the modern battlefield, we'll also include a ballistic, low-altitude drone engagement or blade prototype on our Crows. The blade can detect, track, identify, and take down drones with electronic attack, impeding surveillance and potential attacks from weaponized drones. Let's circle back to Mark from ArmorMax and ask what he would do to fortify a Cybertruck.
What we'd do is, when we receive the Cybertruck, we would go in and disassemble it, and then we would reinforce every area. Even though it's already a tough and durable truck, we would go and reinforce the pillar post or A, B, and C post. We would put reinforced glass into the vehicle. Yeah, we don't use stainless steel. We use ballistic steel in our vehicles. And then we also use composite materials. And then we use ballistic glass. So essentially, it's a series of layers that we're putting into the car. So not only would it be a higher advancement than what Tesla's offering, because it's an aftermarket solution, it would be bulletproof all around. Whereas the Tesla Cybertruck is only armored or bulletproof up to a 9mm. So there's a lot of options that our company offers that are kind of cool that we put on other Teslas, anything from siren systems to strobe lights. We have shocking door handles that we put on other cars on the Teslas. It doesn't work so well because they're recessed door handles. But we do tack dispensers. We have a smoke screen system that we put on these cars. So there's a lot of cool James Bond-like features that a lot of people like to have in addition to the armor.
Just for pure comedy's sake, do you guys think you'd be able to reroute some of the juice from the internal Cybertruck battery to those electrified door handles?
For sure. I think we could certainly try. I think there's a lot of wattage there, so that's a great idea. But yeah, I think we could either put an external battery or reroute from the Tesla's own configuration to do our own shocking system. So yeah, that'd be pretty cool.
Yeah, I think at full output, it would probably blow someone's arm clean off.
Yeah.
Literally. The Cybertruck has some standard features that would really come in handy in a dystopian nightmare, such as the Bioweapon Defense mode, the same hospital-grade air filtration that was available in earlier Tesla Model X and Model S's, which Tesla says is 100 times more effective than premium automotive filters, as it removes at least 99.97% of fine particulate matter and provides protection against chemical, biological, radiological, or nuclear threats, including viruses. And I can think of a few recent situations where something like that might come in handy. The future of military vehicles is electrified. Donald Sando, deputy to the commanding general of the U.S. Army's Maneuver Center of Excellence, says, "In 10 years, some of our brigade combat teams will be all electric." Sando speculates the M1 Abrams could be replaced with a next-generation combat vehicle, like a 75-ton electric tank powered by high-capacity batteries. The U.S. Army Combat Capabilities Development Command has been trying to overcome the hurdles of electric vehicle technology for decades. The potential benefits include lower cost, improved performance, engine decentralization, stealthier operation, and even direct usage as an ancillary power source in theater. Army Futures Command Lieutenant General Eric Wesley said the U.S. Army is seeking to power its brigades using electric and hybrid sources in order to break free of the burden of fuel and disposable batteries that bog down its logistics tail and limit mobility and reach. "It won't be without challenges. Fuel has a long history of reliable service and deeply ingrained infrastructure." But the commander of Army Research, Development, and Engineering Command, Major General Cedric Wins, has said that the Army plans to leverage innovation driven by commercial industry. The Burley Cybertruck and Tesla's extensive supercharger network may very well be one such relevant civilian technology. Elon Musk is not opposed to participating in military efforts. In fact, his company SpaceX was contracted by the U.S. Air Force to launch classified payloads. Musk was the keynote speaker at the Air Force Association's annual Air Warfare Symposium, where he praised the Space Force, stressed the importance of military innovation, and boldly claimed that the fighter jet era has passed and drone warfare is the future. The United States military is also doing some high-voltage research of their own. DARPA's GroundX vehicle incorporates 20-inch rims that pack a 100-kilowatt electric motor with three gears and heat management directly inside the wheel. DARPA says the design offers numerous potential benefits for combat vehicles, such as heightened acceleration and maneuverability with optimal torque, traction, power, and speed over rough or smooth terrain. For reliable power, you need a functioning power grid anywhere you plan to operate. Perhaps alternative power solutions are in store for the future as well. Solar panels on cars are an intriguing concept, but the technology is not yet viable to charge the Cybertruck's massive batteries with an onboard photovoltaic system. Equipping the Cybertruck's roof with a solar power system could be useful to charge an auxiliary battery that powers the vehicle's onboard equipment and could provide an additional layer of redundancy for vital systems. Long charge times are a concern for any application where you may need to get a vehicle back into action quickly. Tesla's supercharger network has made strides in DC fast charging technology. At peak efficiency, a Tesla Model 3 long-range car can gain 75 miles of charge in 5 minutes and charge at rates up to 1,000 miles per hour. We know that Tesla has been working on a rapid, swappable battery technology for several years that could eliminate the need for charging and swap in a fully charged battery pack in minutes. You can see how commercial EV infrastructure initiatives such as this can become dual-use technologies. The Cybertruck's performance characteristics, sturdy chassis, and durability have definitely sparked real-world interest in law enforcement agencies across the world, and many police departments have already put in their orders for Cybertrucks that they plan to convert into operational police vehicles. Mexican Mayor Adrian Esper Cardenas of Ciudad Valles was excited to announce his department put in an order of 15 Cybertrucks to hunt down bad hombres in a more eco-friendly manner. The Dubai Police Department posted this render shortly after the Cybertruck's official launch event. And up north in Canada, the Ontario Police Department tweeted this Cybertruck render at Elon Musk. "One thing's for sure, you definitely don't want to get into a police chase with this bad boy, especially if my friend Donut Operator is driving." The Cybertruck comes with Autopilot-capable hardware today and full self-driving capabilities in the future through software updates. Surround cameras provide 360-degree visibility around the truck at up to 250 meters range, and a forward-facing radar system provides enhanced coverage. This torrent of data is processed by Tesla's proprietary neural net software. Full autonomous, self-driving tech could have serious implications when used in a combat scenario. Firing out the window in hot pursuit, operating comms, or performing other mission-critical activities while the Cybertruck drives itself would be a game-changer. Utilizing Tesla's summon mode to come save your butt in a fight or provide moving cover is another interesting application. Teslas regularly receive over-the-air software updates that add new features and make improvements. The Palo Alto automaker has an ethos deeply rooted in software development and ships forward-looking vehicles with a surplus of hardware capabilities. Tesla has announced no plans or interest in doing so, but we'd sure love to see what kind of software updates Tesla engineers could devise to extend the Cybertruck's tactical capabilities. Tesla disrupted the massive light-duty truck category with its cyberpunk-inspired electric pickup truck that looks like a pointy metal box, but accelerates like a supercar and tows like a Mack truck. Equipped with the modifications and upgrades we mentioned here, it could make a formidable futuristic combat vehicle. Oh, and by the way, we're actually going to build one, probably minus the weapons. Mark from ArmorMax has a Cybertruck on order, and as soon as it's delivered, I'm going to Utah to make a video on the armoring process, and we will definitely be shooting at it when it's finished. If you want behind-the-scenes updates on that, and to hear about some other projects I'm working on, check the link at the bottom of the description to subscribe to our email list. I want to thank my friend Jan Pizard of Pizard Designs for collaborating with me on the renders. You can find him on Instagram and YouTube. If you enjoyed this video, please like it and subscribe to our channel. We showcase cutting-edge technology, including electric vehicles, solar, green energy, various gadgets, and a lot of Tesla. Thanks for watching, and stay safe out there.